Welcome to Coffee Break, 5 minutes with God, 5 minutes in the Word of God, 5 minutes designed to taste and see that the Lord is good. Reading today from Jonah chapter 2, verse 1, then Jonah prayed unto the Lord his God out of the fish's belly. Well, since he figures he's about to die, Jonah decides it would probably be a good time to stop running from God and instead pray to him. So he does. The Lord graciously allowed him to live inside of that fish. And before you say that's impossible, it's not impossible. It's been done. It's been witnessed by people where people have actually survived inside of big whales, and they come out white as a sheet from the stomach acid, but they did survive. So Jonah is not the only one, but he was the only one who was sent this whale as a judgment. And he said, I cried by reason of mine affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me. Out of the belly of Sheol cried I, and thou heardest my voice. For thou hadst cast me into the deep, in the midst of the seas, and the floods compassed me about. All thy billows and thy waves passed over me. The sailors threw him overboard, but Jonah knew that God allowed it to happen in order to wake him up and get him to repent. And if being close to death doesn't cause someone to repent, well, I don't know. There's not much you can do at that point. Their hearts are hard, calloused as can be. The truth can't even penetrate. If God can't get our attention during good times, he will do his best to get it during bad times. We can do it God's way, or we can do it our way, which is the hard way. Might as well just repent right away, because God is God, and you're going to have to deal with him. And if you get to the point where you no longer feel the need to repent, even when you're facing death, well, you've pushed it too far. Your next stop is hell. Verse 4. Then I said, I am cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again toward thine holy temple. Notice how Jonah had hope after he repented and prayed. There's a change in this man already, even though he's still in his situation. He's still inside that fish for now. But he had hope because he repented. He knew he was right with God. There's nothing that can substitute for being right with God and knowing it. 5, the waters compassed me about, even to the soul. The depth closed me round about. The weeds were wrapped about my head. Well, panic must have really set in when he found himself inside of that whale, engulfed in water and seaweed. Panic is an understatement. 6, I went down to the bottoms of the mountains. The earth with its bars was about me forever. Yet hast thou brought up my life from corruption, O Lord, my God. When my soul fainted within me, I remembered the Lord, and my prayer came in unto thee, into thine holy temple. He was as close to being dead without being dead that anyone could be. But God rescued him when he cried out to him with repentance and humility. You can study all of the Bible with me, verse by verse, using my audio Bible messages at thebibleversebyverse.com. Remember, there you will find 4 complete series going through all 31,000 plus verses of Holy Scripture, going back over 36 years here of Scripture verse by verse. You choose, you click, you listen, bring your Bible. That's all you need to be a part of Scripture verse by verse and Coffee Break. Pray for me in God's Word. That will make you an immediate part of this ministry. Also, when you take a break from studying with me at thebibleversebyverse.com, go to the front page, click the donate button, and prayerfully give as the Lord may lead. That also will make you a part of this ministry. See you next time.